Ken Dorsey just broke his silence on the firing by Sean McDermott. NBC releases an article here interviewing Ken Dorsey in the words that were exchanged after he was signed as the offensive coordinator for the Cleveland Browns. Ken Dorsey on the Bills firing said that Sean McDermott decided to make a change, and Dorsey went on to say that he's moved on. Dorsey went on to say that his firing in Buffalo during the 2023 season was purely head coach Sean McDermott's decision, and there's no looking back on it. Dorsey's exact words were that the head coach decided to make a change, and that's something that I've turned the page on. I'm really excited to be here, and I'm more focused on this opportunity than what happened there. Now, you hear what happened in Buffalo, the players not necessarily having fun. Yes, it was ultimately Sean McDermott's decision, but I think Sean McDermott had to make this move in order to save the locker room. Players like Stephon Diggs, Gabe Davis, Josh Allen being a shadow of himself. We just weren't having fun. Players weren't helping one another off the field. And I really think Ken Dorsey kind of sucked the life out of the Buffalo Bills offense. Dorsey said during his time without a job, he evaluated the work he had done in Buffalo and what he will want to do at his next job. Dorsey's exact word says, "It gave me time to go back and look at it. Here's what we're going to do schematically and how we're utilizing our personnel and really evaluate what we're doing. There's always things that maybe I do a little bit differently moving forward." Now, Dorsey admitted a lot in this statement here, and one thing that Joe Brady said after he took over, and Joe Brady said was the reason for his firing in the Carolina Panthers when he was there as offensive coordinator, was just trying to do too much and not necessarily doing what your players do best, trying to simplify things. Honestly, I think Ken Dorsey's biggest problem was that he was just too smart. He was trying to call too many different packages, too many different personnel packages and plays and formations, when he should have just been focusing on doing what his players do best to simplify things. Another thing that we heard Gabe Davis say was that we should just try to simplify things even when Ken Dorsey was here. We saw it during the no-huddle offense. The Buffalo Bills were still doing very well, and that's because during the no-huddle or the two-minute drill, things do get simplified. Dorsey saying what we're doing schematically, right? And I think that really relates to simplifying things and not trying to do too much. And then he also says how we're utilizing our personnel. Again, doing what your players do best, not putting them in positions that they don't feel comfortable or what they're not that great at. And Ken Dorsey finally said, really evaluate what they're doing overall as an offense. What are you trying to accomplish as an offense? On offense, you need to make sure that you're dictating to the opposing defense. As soon as that defense starts dictating to you and you start adjusting your scheme, your personnel based on what the defense is giving you, that's not putting you in an advantageous position. Kevin Stefanski, the Cleveland Browns head coach, was also interviewed on the hiring of Ken Dorsey. And I think we could draw further conclusions here with Ken Dorsey. But Stefanski said that Ken has worked with and evaluated some of the top quarterbacks in this league, mainly Cam Newton being his quarterback coach the year he won NFL MVP, and also Josh Allen. And Stefanski said that he will bring a fresh perspective and approach to their offense. He knows what it takes to be successful at the position, being that he played quarterback in college and was one of the best quarterbacks in all time in college. And Stefanski said it's helped him become a tremendous coach. Don't forget, Josh Allen was very high on Ken Dorsey and put a lot of blame on himself for the firing of Ken Dorsey. But again, I think the Buffalo Bills were just overcomplicated. The Bills players weren't having fun. We weren't simplified. We weren't doing what our players did best. This was a really great learning experience for Ken Dorsey. Just like Josh Allen says, no matter where he goes, and now on the Cleveland Browns, he's likely going to do well. But now Joe Brady had a leg up on Ken Dorsey in the sense that he had an experience as an offensive coordinator with the Carolina Panthers, got fired, already went through this whole entire process, is now with the Buffalo Bills after a fresh start, after understanding the Buffalo Bills team, understanding what works, what doesn't work, really learning behind Brian Daboll, learning behind Ken Dorsey, seeing all of this transpire right in front of Joe Brady has ultimately made him a better offensive coordinator. Stefanski says that he has history with the Cleveland Browns and knows what the Browns mean to the city. We are very excited to bring him in as our offensive coordinator. The other problem I saw with Ken Dorsey was the lack of explosive plays. Really having this short intermediate route tree, trying to utilize our players' rack or run after catch ability. And yes, you still have to have rack, and that's something that Sean McDermott and the Brandon Bean and everyone that has been here that we've really been preaching on, but I think we overemphasized it a little bit too much during the 2023 season. We should have had more plays schematically creating chunk yardage versus just relying on our players to have run after catch. Yes, it's great to have run after catch, don't get me wrong, but I think we need to design some plays here to get more explosive plays, and Ken Dorsey didn't necessarily have that. But Joe Brady, now being able to put his own flair on this offense, being able to understand everything that's unfolded, including the players and everything that we have, Joe Brady was handcuffed during the season, really having to utilize Ken Dorsey's playbook and his schemes and everything that he dialed up and prepared for the 2023 season. But now Joe Brady is going to have a full off season to prepare things for himself, to put his own spice on this offense, to dial things up, going all the way back to LSU when he had Ja'Marr Chase and Justin Jefferson and Joe Burrow. He understands what it takes to run an efficient, potent, chunk yardage offense, one of the best offenses that we've seen in college football. Yes, Ken Dorsey, one of the best quarterbacks in college football, but Joe Brady managed one of the best Hall of Fame type offensive groups in college with Joe Burrow, Justin Jefferson, and Ja'Marr Chase. He's bringing that expertise to the Buffalo Bills, and sure enough, the Bills are looking for two dynamic wide receivers on this team to free up Stephon Diggs. Think about it. Joe Brady knows exactly how to utilize two number one wide receivers instead of having a number one wide receiver in Stephon Diggs and a number two in Gabe Davis. We want two number one wide receivers on this team, and then mixing in the middle of the field with Khalil Shakir, with Dalton Kincaid, even Dawson Knox. The Buffalo Bills are going to be well prepared for the 2024 season. We have also turned the page from Ken Dorsey. Clearly, we have a better offensive coordinator, a fresh young mind, and Joe Brady and the Brady Bunch bring in some dynamic things schematically, personnel-wise, to the Buffalo Bills in 2024. No hard feelings with Ken Dorsey at all. I just think it was the right move by Sean McDermott. Based on this article, it was strictly Sean McDermott's move to move on from Ken Dorsey. Clearly, it was the right move, being that we won the last five regular season games, won in the playoffs. I mean, this is a great sign to see that Buffalo Bills finally have an offensive coordinator in Joe Brady. We have Bobby Babbage as our defensive coordinator. We don't know if he's going to be calling plays, but delegating a lot to a defensive coordinator is definitely going to free things up for Sean McDermott in 2024. But I appreciate you guys all so much. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit like, subscribe. That's how you're going to support me and for keeping this channel alive. 80% of you are not subscribed to the channel, so just make sure you are subscribed. Drop a comment down below on your thoughts of Ken Dorsey. You think Ken Dorsey is going to do well with the Cleveland Browns? Clearly, the Bills made the right move moving on to Joe Brady. Appreciate you guys all so much. Hit like, subscribe, and go Bills.